Okay, students, let us continue. The amount paid for previous year should be subtracted because that is not belonging to the current year. Let us assume that it is 6,000 rupees. So 6,000 rupees and subtracting, then the balance will be 34,000. Okay, amount paid for previous year, last year. So this is otherwise called as outstanding for previous year. Outstanding for previous year. Okay. Like that, this year we are supposed to pay the amount for stationery, but we have not yet paid. The amount we are supposed to pay, we have not yet paid. It means that is called as current year outstanding. We have purchased the stationery for on credit basis. We have to pay the amount to the persons, to the outsider. That's a creditors we have to pay. Even though we have not paid, according to accrual basis, we have to add. That's why add current year 2018-19 outstanding. Current year outstanding, it means creditors at the closing date, closing creditors, because we have to pay money to the creditors only. It is otherwise called as the closing creditors. We have to pay. This is the opening creditors. Opening time, last year closing creditor, we would have paid this year. Then current year outstanding, we have to add. Maybe let us keep an example of 10,000. The total will be 44,000. Okay. Next one, in adjustment, they may give some opening stock. Opening stock means last year closing stock, this year opening stock. It means that opening stock we will be using in the current year or not. Yes, we will be using in the current year. For example, your mother purchased the rice for the last month. Some quantity of the rice, or 2 kg, it was left over. That rice, will the mother throw away? No. Mother will be using for the current year. The same way, the stock of stationery, last year closing will be a opening stock. That opening stock we will be using. That's why we have to add opening stock of stationery. Opening stock of stationery, maybe 15,000. Let us keep an example, 15,000 opening stock. That means total will be 59,000 rupees. Then another adjustment they may give is closing stock of machinery. Like opening stock, we may have some machinery which we have not used for the current year. That we have to subtract. Why we have to subtract? Because that amount of stationery we have not used in the current year. It may be used later. So we have to subtract closing stock of stationery. Maybe 6,000. So closing stock of stationery, say 6,000, that has to be subtracted. So 53,000. Okay, student? Then, sir, this many adjustment only will come, or some more adjustment may also come. If you ask the question, two more adjustments may come. Next year stationery amount we might have paid this year. The stationery what we are going to buy for the next year, we have paid this year. It means that stationery we will be using in the next year or current year. The stationery has not yet come. It will come in the next year only. So next year amount, if you pay current year, that is not belonging to the current year because we are not using in the current year. That's why we have to subtract paid in advance. Paid in advance or prepaid. Are prepaid for the current year. Current year we have paid. Current year means 2018-19. It means, for example, we can have the example of 7,000 rupees. So 7,000 rupees we have to subtract 46,000. Okay. This year we have paid in advance for the next year, that we have to subtract. Like this, last year we would have paid the money for the current year stationery. Okay, it's a last year prepaid. The last year prepaid, we paid last year, but stationery has come this year. So we will be using the stationery in the current year or not? Yes, we will be using in the current year. That's why we have to add prepaid in previous year. Prepaid in previous year 17-18, because that will be used in the current year. That may be for 5,000 rupees. If you add, it will be 51,000 rupees. The 51,000 is the actual amount of cost of stationery consumed during the year. This is the amount will be transferred to the income and expenditure account, expenditure side. Dear students, this two way you can express. One way as a summary, separately you can show as a working. The final amount will be transferred to the income and expenditure account, expenditure side. Stationery consumed. Stationery consumed. 51,000 rupees. You can record it in the after column. Or else you can show this all deals in the income and expenditure account in the inner column. The final amount will be in after column according to our convenience. This will have a workings like that. So like that, one by one we have to do, add or subtract. Then the resultant amount will be recorded in the income and expenditure account. Two ways you can show it as per your convenience. Anyway, the working is very important, whether you are showing separately or in the income and expenditure itself. So this is called the cost of stationery consumed during the particular year we are calculating. Listen very carefully. You can ask one more question. Sir, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 adjustments will be given for one item, sir. It may not be given. They may be giving one adjustment or two adjustments or three. According to the problem you have to do. Now, I imagine that all the possible adjustments I have told, and each and one whether it should be added or subtracted, I have explained to you. So, if you know all the possible items, whatever items coming in the examination, you will automatically will be working out in the examination. This is the way you have to calculate. So, in fixed asset, you might have had the depreciation. Depreciation means actual amount of usage. 1 lakh machinery is there, building is there. 1 year depreciation is 5%. It means 5% of 1 lakh is 5,000. The 5,000 depreciation we are recording here. The same way, this consumable item also we will be using, that is called almost like depreciation. This calculation also like depreciation only. This is the item of consumable frequently, but the machinery and all, machinery will not come in the not-for-profit organization. The building depreciation and other fixed asset depreciation mean they will be giving us a percentage. If they give us a percentage, you can easily calculate the percentage and record it. For that, I will be separately explaining that one. At present, I have explained to you how to calculate the cost of consumables or the amount of stationery debited to income and expenditure account. Okay? So, apart from this, I will be giving one explanation for the fixed asset like building or sports material. I will be explaining in the next class. Thank you very much. Thank you, students.